As COVID cases see an uptick across the country, several states have tightened the noose to mitigate the spread of the virus during the festive season. The Maharashtra government has issued new guidelines amidst the Omicron surge. The state government announced night curfew. Gathering of over 5 people in public places across the state is prohibited from 9 p.m. to 6 a.m. 50% capacity for gyms, spa, hotels, theatre, cinema hall has also been announced. Night curfew also returns in UP between 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. The cap on the number of people attending events like marriages has been limited to 200. COVID curbs have been extended till 31st of December in Delhi. Banned to continue on social and cultural gatherings in Delhi. No New Year Eve parties in Delhi this year. Karnataka has also issued new norms. Night curfew has been announced for 10 days starting 28th of December. Mass public gatherings and celebrations have been banned. Haryana, MP and Gujarat have also imposed night curfew. Tamil Nadu has made 7-day quarantine mandatory for foreign passengers and RT-PCR tests on 8th day. 422 cases of Omicron variant have been reported across 17 states in India and 130 people have recovered from infection, according to the Health Ministry.
A very, very welcome announcement. We thank Honorable Prime Minister for announcing this. Honorable CM had already told that we should be in the forefront because already in regular vaccination, in the first 4 months, Tamil Nadu showed maximum vaccine hesitancy. Similarly, we have identified 33.2 lakh students 15 to 18 years who have to be vaccinated. All those who are very active in public life have taken. They are seeking booster dose. So this announcement is also very useful for them because they are desperate to take that additional dose.
The festive season is on throughout the world and everyone is celebrating, but something that we cannot forget is that COVID cases are also rising. 7 cases of Omicron have been reported in West Bengal. 6 of them are stable. 1 has been de-infected. However, as multiple states and cities are coming up with restrictions and night curfews, West Bengal government has completely gone away with the night curfew for the last 1 week of the festive season. And right now, we are here in front of the Alipur Zoo, and it is one of the oldest zoological gardens in the world. What we can see over here, the situation looks a bit frightening because social distancing is something that cannot be seen over here, and there's a huge crowd that has come over here. The visual that we are seeing right now are of an overbridge where everything is being seen apart from social distancing at a time when everyone claims for the need to have a social distancing measures. That is something that is not being seen, at least in front of us right now. As stated, there is no night curfew for the last 1 week of the festive season in West Bengal, and 7 cases of Omicron have been reported so far, wherein 1 has been cured and 6 are stable. With camera person Shyamchandra Ghosh, Suryagni Roy, India Today, Kolkata.
Saurabh Akhtania is now joining us from Mumbai with all the very latest. Saurabh, what are you picking up as far as the guidelines in Mumbai are concerned? So all the viewers who are tuning in from Mumbai should know the do's and don'ts ahead of the New Year Eve festivities. Over to you, Saurabh.
So Chaiti, first of all, a lot of bookings were already done in last week, and let me tell you, the hotel industries had prepared a lot for the New Year parties because the guidelines which earlier were issued by the Maharashtra government, especially BMC, that yes, some sort of relaxation was given, that the 50% crowd at indoors and 25% crowd at outdoor party was allowed. But as the Omicron cases were continuously increasing, and especially let me tell you, the highest cases of Omicrons were being reported in the city of Mumbai, and now therefore taking no chances, all the New Year parties are completely stands cancelled. Most importantly, night curfew is imposed from 9 p.m. in the night to 5 a.m. in the morning. And let me tell you, more than 5 people are not allowed. The maximum thing is that the house party also, what the police officials and BMC officials are telling, that they will be keeping check at all the places, not just the restaurants, but the societies and the buildings, all the where the checks will be done, that no violations has been done. And therefore, taking no chances, complete ban on parties in the city of Mumbai. A night curfew is imposed. Not more than 5 people are allowed at a time. So, and the war room is now activated completely. So, these are the guidelines which are issued by the state government of Maharashtra and by the BMC officials for the city of Mumbai. But remember what they are saying, if the cases of Omicron continues to increase, and we are seeing slight rise in the cases of daily cases in the city of Mumbai. So, more stricter guidelines and curbs can be issued if cases
continue. So, New Year's Eve plans are going to go for a toss for sure, Saurabh, but it's important amidst the threat of the virus which is looming large, the Omicron variant of COVID. Stay with us. Let's take this across to Shreya as well. Shreya, we see that Mumbai is going to get impacted as far as New Year Eve celebrations are concerned. Life was slowly limping back to normalcy even in Delhi. But now with Omicron variant, a lot of these activities and social gatherings have a cap and there are many restrictions. So just tell our viewers what is allowed, what is not.
Well, yes, you know, in Delhi also, there are certain restrictions that have been put in place by the Delhi Disaster Management Authority. Now, definitely large gatherings are completely banned. So there's no place for Christmas parties that we already saw. And even on the upcoming New Year, the ban stays. What we also do know that the seating capacity for restaurants stays at 50%. And for gatherings and marriages, the limit is 200. So that's overall the limitations that have been put in place. But clearly what has not been allowed is any kind of large gatherings or social events. So definitely that will stay till the end of the year, as has been made the norm by the Delhi Disaster Management Authority, given the rise of the Omicron cases.
That's right. Let's take this across to Pramod Madhav as well from Chennai. Pramod, the same goes for Chennai. What are the do's and don'ts at the moment? What are the latest guidelines, I beg your pardon?
Well, Chaiti, for the state of Tamil Nadu, especially Chennai, also like is a place where during New Year you see a lot of celebrations. Last year we didn't have anything, but this year the Chief Minister has said that he has met with the officials, he has met with a high team of experts, and very clearly mentioned that the coastal areas, the beaches, will not be provided any access to the public, just to make sure that the crowd does not gather over there. Other than that, we don't have any major restrictions. In fact, in the state of Tamil Nadu, in the past 1 week alone, the Omicron cases number increased from 1 to 34. But the health department claims that all those people who had tested Omicron positive, 12 of them have been discharged and everyone are doing well. They are requesting the public to maintain standard operating procedure, wear masks and not to congregate in large numbers in any area, and they are requesting the public to always follow the standard operating procedures, especially to maintain distance and wear masks. Other than that, we do not have any other kind of restrictions in the state, except that the coastal zone, the beaches, no public access will be provided on 31st December and 1st of January of 2022. And the Chief Minister has decided to extend the same lockdown restrictions with relaxations until 31st December.
All right. Thank you, all our reporters from Mumbai, Delhi and Chennai, for joining us, bringing our viewers up to speed with the latest developments as far as the do's and don'ts and the guidelines are concerned. The Omicron threat is looming large, and hence all these guidelines are in place. A late night announcement in the form of Christmas gift. Prime Minister Modi announced a series of moves to boost India's fight against Omicron super mutant threat. Here is all you need to know. Mega boost to fight against Omicron, with super mutant cases continuously peaking. Prime Minister Modi says enough is enough.
2022.
Prime Minister announces boosters and vaccines for kids in Christmas address to the nation. Frontline workers to get booster shots from 10th of January. Comorbids above 60 to be jabbed in first phase of booster drive.
8 वर्ष से ऊपर की आयु के comorbidity वाले नागरिकों को उनके डॉक्टर के सलाह पर वैक्सीन की प्रिकॉशन डोज का विकल्प उनके लिए उपलब्ध होगा, ये भी 10 जनवरी से प्रारंभ होगा.
Prime Minister's booster rollout silences the long-standing demand for booster shots to combat the super mutant variant.
Giving booster doses to people who are vulnerable, again, I think it's very well thought out that it's only the elderly who really are at risk in terms of the Omicron virus. And I think giving them an extra shot is always going to help.
Prime Minister also announced vaccination for kids between 15 and 18 years of age from Jan 3rd.
15 साल से 18 साल की आयु के बीच के जो बच्चे हैं, अब उनके लिए देश में वैक्सीनेशन प्रारंभ होगा. 2022 में 3 जनवरी को सोमवार के दिन से इसकी शुरुआत की जाएगी.
This announcement comes moments after DCGI approved emergency use of Covaxin for children, a two-dose jab.
The best Christmas present we could expect, because we have been actually concerned about the children being unprotected, and the fact that this data that was presented or approved by the scientific committee some weeks ago was with DCGI, who's taken its time to really study the data and put it through the rigors of scientific evaluation. And now that it has been approved for emergency use, which is the normal way of doing it, like it happened for the adults also, it's a big relief.
India will also roll out nasal and DNA vaccines soon.
हमारे देश में जल्दी ही नेजल वैक्सीन और दुनिया की पहली डीएनए वैक्सीन भी शुरू होगी.
From increased number of beds to ample supply of oxygen, the country is on a war footing to tackle the surge.
भारत ने अपनी स्थिति परिस्थिति के अनुसार भारत के वैज्ञानिकों के सुझाव पर ही अपने निर्णय लिए हैं. भारत के वैज्ञानिक भी इस पर पूरी बारीकी से नजर रखे हुए हैं, इस पर काम कर रहे हैं.
The new year will begin with a bang, with the Prime Minister declaring an all-out war against the Omicron surge.
Who will get which booster? Will the double co-vaccinated have to take Covaxin, or whether Covaxin takers will go for Covishield? How much amount of dose will the precautionary dose be? And whether it will be free for those above the age of 60 with comorbidities. These are some of the questions that will require clarity before the big rollout begins in January 2022. Milan Sharma for India Today.